Welcome back. Last week's video was such a hit that as promised, I'm bringing you Ranch Kids Part 2. Each and every comment was so relatable and so dang funny. So I picked some of my favorites and I added in a few new stories of my own. So here are the top ways you might be a ranch kid part dos. Well, you might be a ranch kid if half of the Tupperware in your fridge reads colostrum in permanent marker. Years later, when the colostrum is long gone, you will still be explaining what colostrum is to your coworkers in the break room, while all you really wanted to do was just enjoy your lunch in peace. If you've never had your own head caught in a headgate, you're no ranch kid, either by accident or more oftentimes on purpose at the hand of your sweet, sweet sibling. And now every ranch kid I know, oh, we've all done it. We've brilliantly decided to rope something and thought, there's no way in hell I'm going to catch, only to watch the loop fall on in pure amazement that immediately turns to horror. Getting drugged, tearing parts off the truck, peeling all the skin off your hands, and providing a remember that time story that is sure to go down in history as one of the all-time greats is likely. Flu shots are great, but ranch kids, oh no, they get vaccinated for a whole assortment of things. From blackleg to everything in between, it's actually kind of hard to keep track of all the vaccinations. They're usually accidental, thanks to needles that just miraculously end up stuck everywhere but in the animal they were intended for. Duct tape and baling wire fix all of life's problems growing up on the ranch. If you've never used duct tape to tape hand warmers to your butt in the dead of winter, use it to make a makeshift window when you bust the back windshield out of your truck, cranking that gooseneck just a little too hard, or if you've never used baling wire to fix, well, everything, then you're not a ranch kid. If you loudly have full discussions about semen over dinner at a nice restaurant, you probably grew up on a ranch, we hope. And if your meal at home occasionally had a first name, you were a ranch kid who was learning some real life lessons. Ranch kids are oftentimes excellent actors too. If you've ever watched someone in the family get bucked off or run over, you immediately express concern for their well-being, but on the inside, you try not to pee your pants with laughter. And a ranch kid knows that only years later will it be safe to relive that story over the dinner table. And true ranch kids, they know that the most colossal fights in family history will go down each time you work livestock. Because, well, we're all bred to always be the smartest one in the pen. Reading minds is expected, and it's always the other guy's fault. Always. Like, how could they be so stupid? If getting the 1 a.m. shift checking calving cows is worse than being grounded, you're a ranch kid. And you are definitely a ranch kid if all of life's major events revolve around livestock and rodeos. Yeah, sorry I'm not gonna be able to make your wedding. Looks like there's a big roping that weekend, but don't worry, I'm sure our other sister will be happy to stand in as maid of honor. Yeah, also, not gonna be able to make your college graduation. It's right in the middle of calving season. You know what, come to think of it, you're not gonna be able to attend that either. We're gonna need all hands on deck, but don't worry, they send those diplomas in the mail. And you know you're a real ranch kid when you bust your lip or split something open and your solution to the profuse hemorrhaging is to just put some vet wrap on it. And if you once glued little round, green, castrate banders to your school project to act as donuts in a kitchen scene from some book you were forced to read, you're a ranch kid. I had so much fun reading all of your stories, you guys. Thank you so much for sharing them. As I've said in the first video, I live in the city now, but I will always be a ranch kid. So follow along with Courtenay DeHoff TV. We've got lots of more fun shenanigans. I'm seeing a cattle show and rodeo version of Ranch Kids coming your way in the near future. I don't know, I'll have to work on that. Because quite honestly, these are just too damn funny and too fun. And in today's world, we need more things that make us smile. So thanks for watching Ranch Kids Part 2.